Here you are, Mr. Breslow. This would be match game 74-0244. Take one.
Get ready to match the star. Charles Nelson Reilly. Brett Summers. Don Adams. Elaine Joyce. Richard Dawson. And Mitzi McCall. As we play the star-studded big money match game 74. And now, here's the host of match game 74.
Thank you very much for the warmth of your welcome. Thank you, Johnny Olson. How is everybody in TV land today? Are you ready for us? Are you ready for them?
Yes.
Myra, stand up for just a second here and do the fashion show. That's it. Just take one twirl around. That's it. Isn't it terrible?
Bella. Yeah.
Now, would you stand up over there?
Is this like before and after, right?
Okay, thank you. Marshall's Road. That's as far as we want to go with that.
Okay. Just as much cleavage as Elaine Joyce.
True, but we're not going to ask you to show.
It's just that it's a little tired.
That's right. Oh, dear. Okay, now let's say hello to our two players here, Sandy Corey and Chris Burt here. Hello there, ladies. Sandy is our current champ. She's won a lot of money. She's got $2,400 to her credit. And she's going to be challenged now by this lady whom we're meeting for the first time. How are you, Chris?
Akosti.
Oh, ya sam dobro. Hvala lepa. She speaks a language that I happen to speak, which is Serbo-Croatian. How did you speak? How do you speak Serbo-Croatian?
I happen to be Serbo-Croatian.
No kidding. Where are your parents from?
From Pittsburgh.
Yay!
What did she speak?
Well, Serbo-Croatian is the national language of Yugoslavia. My parents were born there, and apparently where your grandparents were born there. How did you learn it? Usually the
From
second...
My parents spoke it.
Well, that's very interesting.
It's funny, you don't look Yugo.
Neither do I, but I am. Chris, what else you want to tell us?
Vala lijepo.
That means thank you nicely, and it's a good place to cut out here and pause for this message of interest to one and all assembled on this day. All right, we're ready now. What are we ready for? We're ready for me to push a button, right? Seems to me I've pushed that button before, but I guess I've done. Chris, would you make a selection here?
Yes, B, please.
B is what you want. Chris Burt wants B for Burt.
Okay.
The warden said to the prisoner, I've got good news and bad news. The good news is your sentence has been reduced to 1 year. The bad news is your new cellmate is blank. Did you hear all of that, Chris?
No, would you repeat it?
The warden said to the prisoner, I've got good news and bad news. The good news is your sentence has been reduced to 1 year. The bad news is your new cellmate is blank. Wait a minute. The good news is a sentence has been reduced to 1 year. The bad news is your new cellmate is blank.
Oh!
Does that make a difference?
Oh, I'm going to have to tear out my eyes.
Tear it up and start all over again. Don understood it, apparently.
Perfectly.
Yes, that's because his IQ is 177. Remember that.
Well, he could also tell by the length of his stride.
Yes, the way he walked.
Right. How did he know that?
Charles, did you, yes?
Hurry up, Charles.
Come on, Charles!
It's a half-hour show.
Are we making you nervous, Charles?
We're going to be into the 11 o'clock news, and he's still going to be sitting there.
Captain Kangaroo is waiting in the wings.
He's coughing a little better today, isn't he?
All right, Chris Burton. The warden said to the prisoner, I've got good news and bad news. The good news is your sentence has been reduced to 1 year. The bad news is your new cellmate is...
Jack the Ripper.
Jack the Ripper. Well, now, she's got the right idea.
Yeah.
I don't know how many of the celebrities thought of that, but some evil man is what she had in mind, and she specifically named Jack.
I said public enemy number one.
Well, that's the same idea. We can't match it, but you got the right idea, too, Brett.
Do you know what I put before I understood it?
What?
Raquel Welch.
That ain't bad news, honey.
No, that's when you repeated it in English and stopped speaking in Yugoslavian. I put public enemy number one. Did you steal my answer because you're sick?
Oh, of course. No. Well, I've had the same misunderstanding that Red had, because if he says, now let me see if I get this right. The good news is that you're getting out, right?
The sentence has been reduced,
The sentence has been, and the bad news is that your new cellmate, well, the answer would be Raquel Welch, because that would be bad news, because he's getting out, and he would like to stay if his cellmate is Raquel Welch.
That's what I thought.
I'm sorry, Don, it won't wash. It just won't wash. That's all there is to it.
It's logical.
No. What do you say?
I think he should have been a lawyer.
But I figured, how's he just wants to get out, right? So somebody who could help him get out. And this man could just eat him out of prison. Yul Gibbon.
That's right. There wouldn't be anything left for the others. Just sit down.
Oh, I was feeling Charo, excuse me. I got carried away.
She gets to be Charo every once in a while. And nothing wrong with that. How about you, sir?
Eating hickory bars can be fun. I know the bad news was his cellmate was going to be King Kong.
King Kong! That's bad news. Jack the Ripper's the answer she's looking for. And are we on the same wavelength, Mitzi?
Well, sort of. I know Charlie Brill, my husband, is sitting home saying, God, she's a dummy. But the bad news would be that, and no offense, because I love her, Phyllis Diller.
All right, so... You didn't score at all with that, Chris, and now let's see how Sandy does with her first round question, which reads as follows. The music teacher said to Dumb Dora, dear, you don't play a blank by blowing on it. The music teacher said to Dumb Dora, dear, you don't play a blank by blowing on it. Oh, you're the best. Richard is finished. Isn't he quick? Quick mind.
Yes.
Quick-witted.
Very quick.
Okay.
Is everybody finished except me?
Well, Charles has a cold, and he's a little slow today.
I'm all right now.
He's all right now. Your vocal quality is very resonant when you're
sick. Is it more rugged?
Yes, when you're sick.
Okay. I'll beat up anyone that's in the studio.
Yes, all right. Sick and all. Okay, Sandy, the music teacher said to Dumb Dora, dear, you don't play a blank by blowing on it.
You don't play a piano.
You think that's funny? She thinks that's a funny answer. You don't play a piano by blowing on it. What do you say?
For some reason, this whole day has been Yugoslavian. I said violin.
Violin.
I am sorry, my dear.
Yes. All right, Brett.
I've played a piano by blowing on it.
Oh, really?
Yes, it doesn't work. But I said piano anyway.
You said piano anyway. There's one for you, Sandy. Don?
I would not let Sandy down. Piano.
There it is. That's two. How about you?
Want to bet on it?
I bet you got piano. There it is. That's three for you. How about you, Yul?
Eating pianos can be fun. Piano.
There's another piano. Four. And Mitzi.
My piano is made out of wild hickory nuts.
Hickory wood piano. So that's five for you. Round two coming up in a little bit, but first we've got this message of interest. Hello there. Here we are. I'll push a button, reveal our second round question, and ask Chris to make a selection.
Be again.
You've got to score five to stay in the game. Let's see how it goes for you. Listen carefully. While on vacation at the North Pole, Colonel Sanders was up all night trying to Kentucky fry a blank. He's on vacation at the North Pole, you see. Yep. Stayed up all night trying to Kentucky fry a blank.
Where was his
name? I don't know. I suppose it's
Kentucky fry.
Stayed up all night trying to Kentucky fry a blank at the North Pole. Probably stayed at Santa's house. All right, the upper tier is ready.
No.
And your lower tier is ready.
Yes. We're waiting for sugar.
You should have combed your hair before you came on the air, Elaine.
Oh, why don't you?
All right. Ready to go. Now, Chris, while on vacation at the North Pole, Colonel Sanders was up all night trying to Kentucky fry a...
Elf.
A what?
An elf.
An elf. Getting some groans there. I don't know about that. You got a match five to stay in the game. What do you say, Charles?
I'd say that was just a rally, I heard. My goodness. I said a chepunjik, which in Yugoslavian is a penguin.
Penguin seems to be the answer as we start
well,
this, Chris.
I mean,
now,
only one person?
Well, she's got a match five to stay to achieve a tie there. Brett, what do you say?
Trendsetter.
Thank you.
You must match Brett.
Brett? No, he must match.
She must match you, Brett,
well,
to stay in the game. Elf is her answer.
Yeah,
what's yours?
Well, elves are not real, and Colonel Sanders does have a cannibalistic tendencies, and I said Eskimo.
An Eskimo. So that is not a match, and Sandy wins her third game. Congratulations. All over the place. Congratulations. Another $100 to you. Chris, I'm sorry to see you go. Such a short visit. We were just getting to know one another here.
No.
And we've got a gift for you backstage, together with our thanks. And good luck to you, Chris
okay.
Burke. Goodbye. Okay. You know what this big thing turning around means, don't you?
I sure do.
What does it mean?
You're enough. Well, a lot of money.
What does?
Yeah.
Okay, good for you. That's good to have that much confidence. You got $2,500 now. You're going to try for over $5,000 as we begin this big money super match. We polled a recent studio audience. We got their best response to this. Blank it off. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250. If you match the bottom one, you get $100. Which of the celebrities would you like to get a little help from?
Brett.
Come on, take it off.
Take it off. Okay. All right.
Take it off.
That's enough.
Richard.
Oh, knock it off.
Knock it off. Well, yeah.
Don.
Take it off.
Well, she said that.
I can't help it. I wrote the same thing.
And you can't think of another one.
Oh, I have to think of another one.
Yes.
Give him another second. Wait a minute. Put it off.
Put it off. All right, shall we allow that since he didn't understand he had to come up with another one? So you've got take it off, put it off, and knock it off.
Is there a Yugoslavian translation we could follow or
something?
No,
she's gone. The Yugoslav is gone. Sandy is not the Yugoslav. What do you say? You want to choose one of those or give us one of your own?
Take it off.
Really? Take it off. She's going to take it off. Okay. Watch it there, sir. She's only kidding there. Okay. Now we're looking for take it off, and we're going to find out where it is right up on that board now. May we see the $100 response? Turn it off. Well, hee-ha-ha. Now you think of it, huh? Looking for take it off, here is the $250 response. Knock it off is Richard's offer. You're getting close to it. Let's find out if it's up there. Here is your last chance. Here is the $500 response. Take it off. So you got the $500. That means you now play for 10 times that amount. Are you ready? Okay. You're going to play for $5,000, but before you can collect that, you got to choose one and match one. Which one will it be?
Richard.
Yeah.
Richard. Okay, Richard, get ready to write. Sandy will face me. Here is a $5,000 question. Blankberry. B-E-R-R-Y. Blankberry. All right, he's written his answer. Now it's up to you to think of an answer that you think will match him. Blankberry.
There's so many kinds of berries. I have to guess the right one, huh?
The one that he's written down. It's all you have to do.
Somehow I picture a person from England saying blueberry.
You think he'd say blueberry?
I do, yes.
Really?
Oh, I hope so.
All right, Richard, for $5,000.
What did she say?
Show us your berries.
We don't even have blueberries in England.
You don't have blueberries in England?
We have strawberries.
Strawberries!
Blackberries,
loganberries,
strawberries.
Strawberries, the first thing that I thought of.
We have canberries.
You have cranberries.
No, kenberries.
Kenberries. Okay. Well, listen, you're up to an even $3,000, and you will play another game right after this message. It's a lot of money. Here we are. Hello there. Let's welcome a brand new player. Here is Kendra Plummer. All right, Kendra. How do you feel? Good. Now, Kendra's going to tell us the story of her life.
Well, there's not much to tell. I'm married, and I have a wonderful six-year-old, and I had to climb over boxes to get here because we're getting ready to move back east.
Where are you going to move to?
Just outside of Granny Squirrel Gap, North Carolina.
Really? Are you thrilled about that?
Oh, yeah. I'm jumping up and down.
I take it your husband was transferred there.
No, he left his job here, and he's taking a new position back there.
Well, good luck on that move, and good luck here, too. Shall we begin, ladies? All right. Are you ready, Sandy? Okay. Kendra, as a challenger, would you make a selection?
B, please.
Everybody plays brand new game. Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Here's what it says here. Hey, you remember that great song lyric that went, "Some enchanted evening, you will meet a stranger."
Stick to a Yugoslavian accent, please.
Well, there's a new version now. It goes, "Some enchanted evening, you will meet a blanker." You know the song from South Pacific, Kendra?
Yeah.
"Some enchanted evening, you will meet a stranger." Well, the new version now is, "Some enchanted evening, you will meet a blanker." All right.
Do I look like the Statue of Liberty?
Terrific wig, Brett.
Thank you. It's an old one.
It is. Looks grand.
But, you know.
It's nailed on.
No, Elmer's glue.
Okay, they're all ready. So, Kendra, we need a response from you. "Some enchanted evening, you will meet a blanker."
Streaker.
How many of you have done it? That middle-aged lady raised her hand. Okay. Now, she said, "Some enchanted evening, you will meet a streaker."
I said mugger. I'm sorry.
A mugger.
Well, that's not a good answer.
All
it's
right.
It's negative and it's bad.
It's all right. Don't cry, Charles.
I'm sick.
Everything's all right. Next, Brett.
If he coughs in my direction one more time. Oh. Well, actually, one enchanted evening, I did meet a streaker, and he asked me to go home with him.
Oh, really? A streaker. It said streaker on the card, but that's all right. Spelling doesn't count here. Don Adams.
Go ahead, Don.
I have a very strange answer.
Well, that's because you are a very strange fellow.
I don't understand this answer.
Well, maybe I can
ask my shrink about it.
What does that say?
Sailor.
I'm a charity. Don Adams hopes to meet a sailor on some enchanted evening. Don't write to us, write directly to Don Adams. Yes,
I say write to his wife.
It's my turn.
It's her turn. She's on.
I must be getting Charles' sickness because I said mugger, too.
Aw. Didn't you think of streaker? Did you reject the streaker?
No, I didn't think of it.
Oh, all right. Did you think of streaker?
Pardon?
Kendra's looking for a streaker.
Well, I'll show her one.
All right. There you go. Are you supplying a streaker, a mugger?
I'd like to meet you on some enchanted evening. But unfortunately, I said mugger.
Got another mugger there. That's three muggers. Okay. So there were two streakers, a lot of muggers there, Kendra. And we've got a question for you coming up in a moment or so, Sandy. But first, we've got this for you, America. Here it is. Listen, our time is up, I'm sorry to say. We'll pick it up at this point in the middle of round one. You've scored two, and you have your first round question coming up. Look forward to seeing you next time, ladies. That means 30 seconds.
Oh, I see. I thought he had an accident.
No, he said 30 seconds. That's the standard cue in television and radio.
Oh.
Goodbye, Jenny.
That's my daughter.
Jenny is Mitzi's daughter, and she should be sobering up now, so we thought... The first thing we do is say goodbye, Jenny.
Bye, what does that say? Bye-bye, Dickie. Who's that?
Oh, that's me. I'm her son. And I love showbiz.
Okay, well, we'll look forward to seeing all of you next time. And we hope you'll join us next time for Match Game 74. Gene Hickman here. Goodbye. Champ, she's won a lot of money. She's got $2,400 to her credit, and she's going to be challenged now by this lady whom we're meeting for the first time. How are you, Chris?
Acosti.
Oh, ya sam dobro, hvala lepa. She speaks a language that I happen to speak, which is Serbo-Croatian. How do you speak Serbo-Croatian?
I happen to be Serbo-Croatian.
No kidding.
Really?
Where are your parents from?
From Pittsburgh.
Yes.
What did she speak?
What does she speak?
Well, Serbo-Croatian is the national language of Yugoslavia. My parents were born there, and apparently where your grandparents were born there. How did you learn it? Usually the
from
second
my parents spoke it.
Well, that's very interesting.
Funny, you don't look Yugo.
Neither do I, but I am. Chris, what else do you want to tell us?
Vala lijepo.
That means thank you nicely, and it's a good place to cut out here and pause for this message of interest to one and all assembled on this day. Right, we're ready now. What are we ready for? We're ready for me to push a button, right? Seems to me I've pushed that button before, but I guess I've done. Chris, would you make a selection here?
Yes, B, please.
B is what you want. Chris Burt wants B for Burt.
Okay.
The warden said to the prisoner, I've got good news and bad news. The good news is your sentence has been reduced to 1 year. The bad news is your new cellmate is blank. Did you hear all of that, Chris?
No, would you repeat it?
The warden said to the prisoner, I've got good news and bad news. The good news is your sentence has been reduced to 1 year. The bad news is your new cellmate is blank. The good news is a sentence has been reduced to 1 year. The bad news is your new cellmate is blank.
Oh!
Does that make a difference?
Oh, I'm going to have to tear up my answer.
Tear it up and start all over again. Don understood it, apparently.
Perfectly.
Yes, that's because his IQ is 177. Remember that.
Well, he could also tell by the length of his stride.
Yes, the way he walked.
Right. How did he know that?
Charles, did you, yes?
Hurry up, Charles.
Come on, Charles!
It's a half-hour show.
Are we making you nervous, Charles?
We're going to be into the 11 o'clock news, and he's still going to be sitting there.
Captain Kangaroo is waiting in the wings.
Charles, he's trying to get
he's coughing a little better today, isn't he? All right, Chris Burton. The warden said to the prisoner, I've got good news and bad news. The good news is your sentence has been reduced to 1 year. The bad news is your new cellmate is...
Jack the Ripper.
Jack the Ripper. Well, now, she's got the right idea.
Yeah.
I don't know how many of the celebrities thought of that, but some evil man is what she had in mind, and she specifically named Jack.
I said public enemy number one.
Well, that's the same idea. We can't match it, but you got the right idea, too, Brett.
Do you know what I put before I understood it?
What?
Raquel Welch.
That ain't bad news, honey.
No, that's when you repeated it in English and stopped speaking in Yugoslavian. I put public enemy number one. Did you steal my answer because you're sick?
Oh, of course not. Well, I've had the same misunderstanding that Red had, because if he says... Now, let me see if I get this right. The good...
Here you are, Mr. Breslow. This would be match game 74-0244. Take one.
Get ready to match the star. Charles Nelson Reilly. Brett Summers. Don Adams. Elaine Joyce. Richard Dawson. And Mitzi McCall. As we play the star-studded big money match game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rivers!
Thank you very much for the warmth of your welcome. Thank you, Johnny Olson. How is everybody in TV land today? Are you ready for us? Are you ready for them?
Yes.
Myra, stand up for just a second here and do the fashion show. That's it. Just take one twirl around. That's it. Isn't it terrible?
Bella. Yeah.
Now, would you stand up over there?
This is like before and after, right?
It's my... Okay, that's it.
Fascia's Road.
That's as far as we want to go with that.
Okay. Just as much cleavage as Elaine Joyce.
True, but we're not going to ask you to show.
It's just that it's a little tired.
That's right. Oh, dear. Okay, now let's say hello to our two players here, Sandy Corey and Chris Burt here. Hello there, ladies.
News is that you're getting out, right?
The sentence has been reduced, yeah.
And the bad news is that your new cellmate, well, the answer would be Raquel Welch, because that would be bad news, because he's getting out, and he would like to stay if his cellmate is Raquel Welch.
That's
what
I
said.
I'm sorry, Don, it won't wash. It just won't wash. That's all there is
to it. It's logical.
No. What do you say?
I think he should have been a lawyer.
But I figured, he just wants to get out, right? So somebody who could help him get out. And this man could just eat him out of prison.
Yule Gibbons. That's right. There wouldn't be anything left for the others. Just sit down.
Oh, I was feeling Charles, excuse me. I got carried away.
She gets to be Charles every once in a while. And nothing wrong with that. How about you, sir?
Eating hickory bars can be fun. I know the bad news with his cellmate was going to be King Kong.
King Kong! That's bad news. Jack the Ripper's the answer she's looking for. And are we on the same wavelength, Mitzi?
Well, sort of. I know Charlie Brill, my husband, is sitting home saying, God, she's a dummy. But the bad news would be that, and no offense, because I love her, Phyllis Diller.
All right, so... You didn't score at all with that, Chris, and now let's see how Sandy does with her first round question, which reads as follows. The music teacher said to Dumb Dora, dear, you don't play a blank by blowing on it. The music teacher said to Dumb Dora, dear, you don't play a blank by blowing on it. Oh, you're the best. Richard is finished. Isn't he quick?
All
quick mind.
Yes.
Quick-witted.
Very quick.
Okay.
Okay.
Is everybody Let's finished go. Except me?
Well, Charles has a cold, and he's a little slow
I'm
today.
I'm all right now.
He's
Doctor.
All right now. Your vocal quality is very resonant when you're...
Is it more rugged?
Yes, when you're sick.
Okay. I'll beat up anyone that's in the studio.
Yes, all right. Sick and all. Okay, Sandy, the music teacher said to Dumb Dora, dear, you don't play a blank by blowing on it.
You don't play a piano.
You think that's funny? She thinks that's a funny answer. You don't play a piano by blowing on it. What do you say?
For some reason, this whole day has been Yugoslavian. I said violin.
Violin.
I am sorry, my dear.
Yes. All right, Brett.
I've played a piano by blowing on it.
Oh, really?
Yes, it doesn't work. But I said piano anyway.
You said piano anyway. There's one for you, Sandy. Don?
I would not let Sandy down. Piano.
There it is. That's two. How about you?
Want to bet on it?
I bet you got piano. There it is. That's three for you. Perfect. How about you, Yule?
Eating pianos can be fun. Piano.
There it is. Another piano. Four. And Mitzi.
My piano is made out of wild hickory nuts.
Hickory wood piano. So that's...